Welcome to Signal and System lecture series. Here in this session, I'll be going to explain time shifting property of Laplace transform. So earlier I have already explained the basics of properties of Laplace transform, where I have already defined time shifting property even, but here I'll be deriving how that relation is coming for time shifting property of Laplace transform. So let me define it first, and then we will derive that property. Now see, if you have signal x of t and Laplace transform of that is x of s, then time shifting of input will result into time shifting of input that will result into x of t minus t0. So Laplace transform of that will be e to the power minus s t0 x of s. So this is what I have already defined earlier. So when you have time shifting, you'll have to multiply that shifted version of time with e to the power minus s t0 x of s. So that is what time shifting property of Laplace transform. So let us calculate that. Now see, we know what is Laplace transform. So Laplace transform of x of t, that is x of s, and that is minus infinite to infinite x of t e to the power minus s t dt. So if I consider LHS over here, so LHS means x of t minus t0 that we have now. And if I take Laplace transform of it, in that case, Laplace transform of x of t minus t0. So that will be integration minus infinite to infinite x of t minus t0 into e to the power minus st dt. So this is what Laplace transform of x of t minus t0. Now to have this calculation in terms of x of s, what I'll be doing is I'll be considering t minus t0 is equals to some constant. So if I consider t minus t0 is equals to lambda, then one can say t is equals to lambda plus t0. And if you take differentiation, then dt will be equals to d lambda, and limit of this will not change. So you'll be observing now this integration that will be minus infinite to infinite x of lambda e to the power minus s into lambda plus t0 d lambda. And now if I re-elaborate this, then this will be minus infinite to infinite x of lambda. Now see, what I'll be doing is e to the power minus s lambda into e to the power minus s t0 d lambda. I'm just separating this term over here, right? Now this term is constant one, like it is independent of lambda, so this is constant, so you can take it outside of this integration. So if I take it outside of this integration, you'll be finding this is e to the power minus s t0 into integration minus infinite to infinite x of lambda e to the power minus s lambda d lambda. So this is what Laplace transform of function x. This is what Laplace transform of function x. So one can say this is e to the power minus s t0 x of s. So here we can say Laplace transform of signal x t minus t0, that is e to the power minus s t0 x of s. So we can say we have proved this condition, right? So this is what time shifting property of Laplace transform. I hope that you have understood this. So whenever you have been given with any time shifting property of Laplace transform, all you need to do is you just multiply that shifted time period with e to the power minus s t 0 and x of s, and that will result into Laplace transform of that time shifted version signal. Now to explain this term in terms of example, how we need to apply that. So for that, I'll be considering very simple basic example, so it will be clear to all like how we can apply this. Like, see, we have x of s, and that is given by 1 by 2s plus 1. X of s, that is given by 1 by 2s plus 1. And Laplace transform of x of t, that is x of s. So question is, find x of t minus 2. Question is, find x of t minus 2. So how to calculate this? So by using this simple property, we can directly calculate, find Laplace transform, find Laplace transform of x of t minus 2. So how to calculate Laplace transform of x of t minus 2? So by using this time shifting property, we can directly calculate it. So Laplace transform of x of t minus 2, that will be e to the power minus 2t into Laplace transform of x of s. And Laplace transform of x of s, that is given by 1 by s plus 2s plus 1. So we can say this is e to the power minus 2t divided by, sorry, not 2t, 2s, e to the power minus 2s divided by 2s plus 1. See, simply this is how we can calculate Laplace transform by using time shifting property. I hope that you have understood this session. You can give your feedback here in comments. I'm considering all those comments which you are placing here, and in future I'll be making those videos which is required to students, those who are studying here from my channel. Thank you so much for watching this video.